Hey guys, welcome to a new series on the channel. We're going to be doing some Dungeon Defenders going rogue. And I think we are going to start with the Squire on the hard difficulty. Now, I played this game a little bit, but not a whole lot. Got some of the basics down. Alright, so we're going to G up right away. Right now on the DDA post, we are doing a solo squire challenge, so feels just at home. Okay, we're definitely gonna equip that. I don't know if that's actually worth it. That's fine. Yeah, we're definitely gonna want that. Okay, extra jump and ability 10%, we'll take it. Oh yeah, now we're quick. That defense did a lot of damage. They are very, very accurate. Yeah, that's just not worth it. So we turn in 1 HP regen for power, which I'm guessing the power is just going to be better overall, so we'll just keep it. Bouncer blockades, I guess we'll take it in case we end up using them. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. 50% crit chance when Blood Boil is active, we'll take it. Okay, so most of the damage is probably going to be coming from us. And I already know that this is kind of overpowered, so gonna take it. Man, these guys are getting tanky. Sure how my shield missed that, but whatever. Again, shield is not working today. Well, there goes that run. I wish there was a way to speed this up. If you can't respawn, I just don't see why it even lets it go on. Let's try using a different hero. Try the apprentice. Oh, I guess we're on medium difficulty now because it didn't save the setting. Oof, single target weapon. Seems to be doing pretty good damage though. Just really hoping for a weapon there. Okay, it just regens after each wave. Okay, only one projectile still, but it's gotta be better. Attack rate. Definitely doing a lot more damage now, which is really helpful. Especially since the main part of your damage is going to be coming from you in this game. The towers will do a lot of damage, but they just don't stick around for too long, and you can't just rely on them. You can also try to kite the enemies back. The ogre and the orc was not having it though. Yeah, we'll definitely get that. 0.4, a little bit less damage, but there is piercing shot though. I think that's better overall. Okay. What do we got here? Whoa. Okay, well, I'm just gonna take that regardless. It seems like a really good one. G up right away. I don't know if it's like this for everyone else, but this game just stutters a lot for me. It might just be me, but I don't think we're doing piercing damage. Okay. No, it is. Ooh, Flame Burst Tower. Okay, we're definitely taking that with the Lightning Tower. What are you guys thinking about Dungeon Defenders going rogue? I think personally that it was released a little bit too early into the processing stage. It just doesn't really seem like it was fully finished yet. But it definitely is a fun game, that's for sure. I was gonna say if that would hit the crystal right behind me. I do also think that the squire is probably the worst one, at least at clearing just waves. Because I've been playing the squire quite a bit. You know, waves have never gone by this fast. I might not even need to use the defense. Wow. Okay, we'll definitely take a shield. Oh. I mean, I guess we'll take it. Still shoots pretty fast. Let's see. Fires homing projectiles. I just don't think it's really better overall. These are the same tower. Alright, well, grab this. We have our rune, range, armor. Let's take armor. And then we'll just keep it going. Feels weird to see spiders at this difficulty. Like, we're on medium and we have spiders. Like, it's just weird. Like, why would we have spiders on medium? Typically, I don't think spiders are actually introduced until Nightmare. I could be wrong about that, it could just be insane difficulty also, but whatever. Either way, it's not medium. Whoa. It's a little too close for comfort. Now, one thing I do notice is I am a lot squishier than the Squire, for sure. I don't want the... That's probably better. Really? Got one lucky shot off. Yes, yes, I see you, I see you. Oh, yeah, see, they chunk away your health. Okay, we're definitely taking that. Okay. Well, apparently we just grabbed that as well. Do we take the blockade? Power duration. Yeah, let's take it. These guys are so tanky in this mode. I mean, you could just be shooting at the necromancers all day, it seems like. Man, get back here. Ouch, that hurt. Whoa. Okay, we should open our chest before we move on. Okay, this looks juicy. Okay, Deadly Striker. Well, I mean, I'll probably end up using Deadly Striker Towers. I will take your 10%. Okay, this actually does look better. Duration. Yeah. I mean, we'll take it. I just don't think these weapons are actually better. I'm not taking that. Alright, so we have our first boss fight. It should be the Demon Lord. Oh, I landed right in that. Sorry if I got really quiet, these boss fights can be kind of intense. Now I believe you take damage when you go out of that ring. I'm over 100% sure, like, no, but... just the fact of being able to have range on that guy, though, makes the boss fight so much easier than using a squire. Range. Okay, yeah, we're definitely taking that. Okay, we got a lot of speed off this and a lot of haste. We lose armor, though. We do get a better regen chance. Get better shield. A little bit less max HP. I think we're just gonna take it. Oh! Deadly Striker Tower. Okay. Oh, man, though. You know what, let's take it. Bouncing shot again. I don't know, I just don't think it's actually better. Alright, time for Act 2. Well, I guess we'll be working our way up to the Act 2 boss at least. Oh, jeez. I don't know why, whenever you first start one on this game, I swear it's so laggy. Oh. What is attack? Oh. Man, the flyers on this are so annoying. Okay, let's go hit up our chest. Whoa. Okay. Yeah. Gonna have to. Man, this map is too big for this. I'm trying to look at the mini map. Oh wow, that nearly one-shot us actually. I didn't even realize that. Oh! Okay, was not expecting that. Really? Man, that ogre is stupid. Max HP. Haste. Whoa, okay. Yep. Yeah. I don't think there's any reason to not take this. So, gonna take that. Man, we got really lucky on this weapon choice. Is he gonna be? Man, the gin hit really hard. Get out of here. Man, that is so annoying. It just tracks you. That? Okay. Game seems to really like this spot. Oh, what? Okay. Wow. Wow. Yeah, see, this is what I'm talking about, though. There's just nothing you can do at this point because it doesn't respawn you. So, like, why even continue? Like, I can't put up defenses ahead of time because they only last, like, 10 seconds. So it's such a joke. Alright, we're going to be trying the hunters. What level do I need to get the monk? We're just going to go up to our difficulty. The starter weapon is not it. Oh. You see what I mean? There's just, as soon as you die, there's like nothing you can do anyway. And you can't put up defenses. It's, the game is not finished. Not really sure why they would release the game if it's not finished, but okay, for a second I was getting negative hero XP. Perfectly finished game though. I think the hardest part about this is just that the Huntress's weapon just really sucks at first. You guys see what I mean here? Like, yeah, there's pretty much nothing I can do at this point. Unless I can kite them over. Yeah. I don't know. I just don't think that this game was complete and ready to come out. I could be wrong, but it seems like the hard difficulty isn't really actually possible with the Huntress weapon. I haven't seen any gameplay of the game though, so I could be wrong. I mean, we'll try it on medium, but it's definitely better. Okay, we got an extra jump. Get some more HP and speed. I do like how they did add a way for us to get more jumps. Although I will say, sometimes it kind of gets to the point where it's like irrelevant. Like, I know on one time that I was playing, I had like 6 jumps or something crazy like that, and it was just like, I'm never gonna use all this. Okay, we did get a new weapon, but these are normally not very good, at least in the original games, but we'll try it. Poison dart tower. Okay, so it's going off the DD2 towers. Okay. Okay, this thing is actually really cool. I remember in Dungeon Defenders Awakened, a lot of times people never use these weapons because they just weren't reliable. Like, they can be really good damage-wise and spread-wise, but they're just, it's just typically not good enough. Oh no. Oh, piercing shot again. But this is an explosion. Yeah, I'm gonna stick the weapon I got. Okay, so Inferno Trap. We're gonna do that one. Just because the fireballs can actually really help. The necromancers are just way too tanky, I think. Like, look at this. I can, like, sit here and hit this guy all day. Musketeer. Wow, that is a huge damage increase, but there's three projectiles. Nah, not like your current weapon. They're just too tanky. Like, you can just sit here and hit them all day. Did not mean to do that. guess we'll take it. I already have it, but cool. Capability. Okay, we definitely need more HP. Explosive trap. Oh man, I don't know. Yeah, I mean, let's just take it instead of that. I think it is time for a weapon upgrade though. The next weapon that drops will definitely upgrade. Okay, well that's a pretty bad rune. Oh, but that is a good weapon. Do we have a lot of range with this one? Okay, we'll take it. Okay, maybe this weapon is actually pretty garbage. Alright, next weapon that drops we will also grab. Oh, come on. Oh, really? I'm gonna die because of this, aren't I? Jeez. Spider's just absolutely broken. You get hit by him one time, and then they pretty much just have auto-aim on you for the rest. They might as well just kill you. Okay, I'm definitely taking that. Inferno Trap plus 4. I'm gonna take it. Alright. Do a ton of damage. where are they coming from? Okay, let's pick up all this HP real quick. Oh, jeez. That was a nice 16 frames per second there. Definitely want that. Okay, so this has piercing. I do think that this is better. I'm gonna go for it. Let's see. Yeah, I think it's gonna be better overall. I think it's about time for the boss fight. Yep. Well, let's see how this goes. Yeah, the Demon Lord, as long as you have a ranged weapon, he's really not that bad. Okay, yeah, we're definitely taking that then. Alright, on to Act 2. hero attack. Planted here in 20% attack skill and agility when still. Probably not gonna remain still, but whatever. Speed, haste, dodge. Okay, so no regen though. Well, no, it's got the 2% regen on hurt, so we'll just use it. Oh, me. Went the wrong way. It would definitely help fight if we were, if there was multiple people with me too. Like, if you had a 4-man squad, this game would probably be even, maybe even too easy. Depending on how the scaling works too. Okay, I've never seen this before. That's actually pretty useful. Okay, minus 33% ability, but health, skill, dodge, armor, attack, HP regen. Alright, so we're definitely gonna take that. Poison trap. That's a long cooldown though too. No. Oh, we could switch. Nah. We'll stick with what we got for now. Although it probably would have been smart to switch that, but whatever. Yeah, our weapon is not doing much damage anymore. Okay, we're definitely taking that. Armor will take. Dang, did not mean to do that. Just waiting for him to respawn. Okay. Stupid flyers, I really don't see why there's a need to have flyers in the game. They're really just kind of an annoyance. Whoa. Paintball gun. It doesn't have piercing damage though. We'll do it though. Oh. I don't know. There's gotta be some kind of like when you play like Call of Duty, you know how there's like a respawn if you die, but you're solo? They have to have that on here, otherwise it's like this is just stupid at this point. Like, why am I still here? The game is obviously over. You won't let me respawn. So like, why even continue? We're definitely ending that one here. I don't know. The game's cool and all, but I just don't think that it's really that much fun. Not that it's not fun, it's just not done. It just doesn't seem like it was really ready. There's just a lot of things that don't make sense. A lot of things that seem pretty unbalanced. But not here to rant, so. Well, if you watch this far, thank you. Please leave a like and subscribe. And I'm signing off.